boys all lined up, ready for a great trip. It is Saturday afternoon in October, just before Sukkot, and we are in Park Adulam, which is not that far, about 15-20 minutes from Beit Shemesh. And this whole area is made up of limestone caves. You can see the beautiful hills in the area. It's a little more interesting during spring, maybe. But anyway, there are some fantastic caves here and tunnels, which we're going to go and have a look at. So this is my very short introduction, and see you momentarily. So we've come to this first cave, which is a columbarium. A columbarium is a fascinating thing. You're going to see there's all these small niches in the walls of the cave. And it really, really is phenomenal to be here and see what's around. What happened was the cave was, this whole area was actually built like a bell cave. In other words, they would dig in from the surface, take and start excavating a small hole, and then once they'd reached below at a certain depth, they would start, they would continue digging, but around from the sides, and that creates a sort of a bell, not very good at explaining this on a video, but with one hand, but a bell shape of cave, which would mean that this entrance was from a later stage. But really, truly, truly fascinating being here and seeing this. There are quite a number of them around the country. I've seen many more, but this one, this is the first time that I've been here. Surprisingly, to my knowledge. So continuing to walk along the track here, we have just arrived at a burial cave, which was apparently quite grand and in use between, I think it was around the beginning of the first century to around 135 AD, at the time of the Bar Kokhba revolt. That's the Jewish rebellion against the Romans, and according to the signs here, it was vandalized somewhere around 15-20 years ago by vandals. So they say that one of the few things that really shows where we are is the rolling stone that was put in to cover the oh, there you go. We've come now to another columbarium, but look at this. You can see, but my head is really at the ceiling. Very, yeah. Very small, narrow area. But wow, this would have been growing thousands of pigeons. So many secrets, you know. You just walk along middle of nowhere and suddenly you find this interesting stone. Looks like a millstone of some sort. I have no idea. No idea what that little niche was for. The whole area is just so full of secrets. So you're walking along this path, see this sign, and you think, oh yeah, I'll just keep for a bit of a walk. And then you come along here and crikey. That's a big drop down there. So here we've come above onto the hill above where the burial cave was. And this was apparently an ancient synagogue. So let's go up here and see what we can find. This spot is incredibly important. You can see the fantastic view of the whole area. There's the modern city of Beit Shemesh in the background, lit up by the sun.
And at the peak of the hill is Israel's only pyramid. It's a step pyramid, and it's thought to have been either a monument to someone interred in the burial caves below, or as a watchtower over the whole area. One then has to ask, why build a pyramid? So one theory I heard is that this is a Greek design that was influenced from Egypt, which had a Greek dynasty of pharaohs since it was conquered by Alexander the Great. Oh, here we go. This is called the Refuge Cave. Anyway, we're going to... apparently this is the one where people have fun inside. Okay, so we're going to go in and check that out. Well, the Refuge Caves, that's these ones, are a system of underground chambers connected by narrow crawl spaces. Dozens of these systems were discovered in the Judean lowlands. They're assumed to have been dug as part of the Jewish response to the Bar Kokhba revolt. That's the Jewish rebellion against the Romans around 132 AD. The caves served as hiding places from the Roman army for Jewish rebels. Okay. So... okay, let's see if I can go in through here. Oh. Oh. Yeah, look at that. Oof. Okay, so I'm gonna do this. We're in the Bar Kokhba caves. We've crawled in a little while. So we're way underground. This is where the Jews would be hiding from the Romans during the rebellion. Now that was a challenge. Oof.
Indiana Jones,
he had it easy. Oh. Well, that was an amazing day. The boys really were screaming, oh my God, never want to do this again. But then when we got out, they said, oh, this is fantastic, this is amazing. And it really was good. So I hope you enjoy the film. We came on the highway on the way home, and as you can see behind me, there's a whole lot of people here who are eating. There's a Druze family that are making pita and selling to people. So we're going to see if we can get some Druze pita. الله والخمس حدود والسر الفينا موجود الله والخمس حدود والسر الفينا موجود الله والخمس حدود والسر الفينا موجود بني معروف في الاسود منصورة عالطغياني بني معروف في الاسود منصورة عالطغياني الله والخمس حدود تاريخ الماضي نعيده كما لا مع مجيده عنا اليوث الس